Hello, I am Sagar Sutar, a learning experience expert on the Solidworks training team. Today, I am excited to walk you through applying a cable joint in xDesign. We will explore the various options available within this powerful command. So let's dive right into the 3D experience platform and see it in action. For this video, I have three parts in this assembly. The frame is a fixed part and I will add a cable joint between two sliders, slider 1 and slider 2. Let's activate the cable joint command. I will select slider 1 and slider 2 from the graphics area as the components. For the ratio, I will keep 1:1 as is. Now we need to define three sets of mates for each slider, two coincident and one starting distance mate. Let's add the first coincident mate between slider 1 and the frame along the z-axis. Now we will add the second coincident mate between slider 1 and the frame along the x-axis. Let's add the third mate, which is the starting distance mate. The three sets of mates allow slider 1 to slide along the y-axis. Now we will add three sets of mates for slider 2. Similarly, to save the time, I have added three sets of mates for slider 2. The three sets of mates allow slider 2 to slide along the x-axis. I will click OK to complete the command and change the view of the model. The design manager shows that the cable joint has been added successfully. Let's move one of the sliders. As you can see, slider 2 moves in the opposite direction. We will fix this by editing the joint and reversing the drive. Notice that there is a warning icon appearing at the starting distance mates. I will click solve to fix the issue. Now we will recheck the cable joint. I am getting the result as expected. Thanks for watching. For even more great content, click the link in the description below to access the additional tips, tricks, and training courses. And as always, happy modeling.